Hi everyone. I have another quick video for you today, and it's about a situation that every single one of us has probably found ourselves in. You have a threaded part that's been taken out of the machine, and you need to put it back in and find that thread again. Maybe you need to cut the threads farther back along the part, or maybe instead of your part, the tool broke and needed to be taken out and reground. Maybe, just hypothetically speaking, one of your jerkwad coworkers took it out while you were on lunch so they could use the machine to work on their home project that they most certainly should not be using company material and equipment to make, but the rules don't apply to them and they don't care that they ruined your day. And while we're on the subject, why the hell did you use that lathe when there are three others that weren't even being used? Purely hypothetical, of course. Whatever the reason, hit that subscribe button with your coworker's face and let's get started. Once your part's been removed from the lathe, the threads are no longer timed to the gear train, so just slapping it back in the chuck and engaging the half nuts probably isn't going to end well for you. Instead, you have to find where the thread is in its new orientation. This is pretty easy to do. First, make sure that your butt-faced coworker didn't also change the gear settings on the machine and that you're still set up to cut the correct thread. Also, check that your tool is still perpendicular to the part using your center gauge. Now for the fun part. Get your tool in a position where it is definitely not going to touch the part. Then start the lathe and engage the half nuts just like you were cutting a thread. Once the tool is over the threads, stop the machine but leave the half nuts engaged. Now you can move the tool around using a combination of the crossfeed and the compound to get the tool aligned to the existing thread. Your compound will need to be angled for this, even if you're feeding straight in using the crossfeed. That said, if you are threading with the crossfeed, the angle doesn't matter and it can be parallel to the lathe axis if you really want. You just need to be able to move the tool sideways to get it aligned with the thread. To get this lined up nicely, I put some paper underneath the part and then lower my work light close to it so it's easy to see light shining between the tool and the part. This is the same trick I use when setting up the tool with the center gauge. Once you're satisfied that the tool is properly aligned, you can set your dials to zero and commence threading the part. If you have any questions about this or any other machining topic, ask them down in the comments section below and I'll do my best to answer you. Who knows, I may even make a video about it. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you think I've earned it, and maybe check out my Patreon page if you'd like to help support the channel, just like my two newest patrons, Roger Albert and Trond Smevik. Hi Roger and Trond, welcome aboard. You may also want to check out these other videos. Over on the right, I have my ever-growing playlist of quick machining tips videos just like this one. And on the top left, I have my most recent video. And on the bottom left, there's a video that YouTube thinks you'll like just as much as this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.